It's such a loaded and possibly dated term, alpha male. Invariably, this type of guy spends an unhealthy amount of time in a male-only company. He's probably still a bit sexist, even in this day and age. It's not about becoming better than other men, developing an ego complex, or learning how to be an alpha of a specific clique or social circle. It's a matter of learning how to be an alpha male in your life. Take full responsibility for your life, and live every day fully alive, present, and excited for the future that you are creating. It's more about being a leader in your own life, rather than seeking to lead others. So here are Alpha's 12 characteristics. We are starting right now. Number 1. Respect. Be honorable. There's nothing gained from being a pushover, which doesn't mean that knowing how to compromise isn't invaluable. But respect others too, regardless of their background, race, sex, age, or place in life. We're going to get along together when we all recognize that we're not the only person who matters. Don't screw anybody over. True alphas are not in competition with others, but themselves. They're not ogling social media and comparing themselves to other men, and wondering how they can one-up other men. They don't care that Alex just bought a new Mercedes or that Denny got married to a beautiful woman. The only person to whom they compare themselves is the man that they were yesterday. Because that's the only thing that matters. Every day, when you wake up, ask yourself, how can I be 1% better today than I was yesterday? You're not in the best shape of your life because of a great workout and eating healthy for a day. You don't become a millionaire because of a long day of hard work. And you're not going to build an abundant dating life because of one approach. You get into the best shape of your life by lifting just a little more weight today than you did yesterday. You become a millionaire by consistently providing market value and developing highly marketable skills. You build an abundance of dating life by making it a habit of meeting, having fun and connecting with high-quality women on a regular basis. Learning what works and what doesn't, and adjusting your strategy accordingly. Stop looking elsewhere, just embrace that fact. Number 2. You are not always Mr. Right. Nothing good ever comes from senseless arguments to prove that you are Mr. Right. How many successful keyboard warriors or internet trolls can you name from the top of your head? Exactly. None of them. To be an alpha male is to have a massive bias towards action and learning, not an argument. Stop wasting your time arguing about religion, politics, and philosophy with strangers on the internet, or even your best friends, and instead commit to taking action on things you can control and improve yourself. If you cannot act on something and make a change for the better, refrain from making senseless arguments that lead nowhere. All you want to do is alienate the people you probably want to connect with. Number 3. Appreciate your body. You don't need to have 20 inches biceps or rock a six-pack year-round to be an alpha male. But you have to be physically and emotionally fit and build a strong and useful body. Every human being on the planet, man and woman, has a responsibility to take care of their health for themselves and others. Failure to do so will result in a low quality of life. It may not be politically correct, and you may not want to hear it, but it is the truth. True alphas have enough respect for themselves to take care of themselves. In order to make the most of life and fully experience all that this world has to offer, you must be physically and emotionally fit. If you're overweight and out of shape, not only will your quality of life suffer, but your ability to serve the world will suffer. Most of us want to have a long, active life. It's remarkable, then, how much of our behavior is self-destructive. Your body is the only one you have, it needs to be well maintained. This isn't to say that you need biceps of the size of melons, you literally don't. But that means taking care of yourself. Drink if you like, but drink less. Keep your drugs in mind. Don't smoke, man. Get a lot of sleep. Eat well and moderately. Exercise regularly, not maniacally. Number 4. Follow your goals and live by your values. Alpha males are living by their own code. They know what they value, and they're living in integrity with those values. One of the leading causes of anxiety, depression, and existential anguish is living a life that is misaligned with your values. If you say to yourself, I value my family, or partner, but you spend every waking hour at work, and can't remember the last time you went on a date night or spent time with your kids. This misalignment will eat you like cancer, until it spirals out of control, usually in the form of divorce papers. The key to a happy and successful life is a radical alignment of what you think, say, and do. If you act out of alignment with your values, it creates a sense of distrust of others and even of yourself. It shows that you are not capable of acting on the things that are most important to you. So take some time this week to identify your values and ask if your actions in the last 30 days reflect those values. There are no correct or wrong answers here. You could be an alpha male, whether you value financial success, family, friends, social impact, or adventure. What matters most is that the values you write down are true to you, and that you live by them every single day. Number 5. Know and acknowledge your weaknesses. The traditional alpha male did not admit any flaws or limitations. He was a hero of his own comic book, without the kryptonite. But there is a point where admirable self-confidence becomes self-delusion. You can't do it all. You can't be all of it. You are through genetics and circumstances, who you are. Aim for improvement, of course. Make the proper changes where they are called for. But also embrace this liberating fact. Number 6. Master attraction, charm, and seduction. If you want to become an alpha, you need to learn and master the art of authentic attraction. The reason for this is simple. A man who lacks confidence in his ability to attract the kind of people he wants into his life is a man who is destined to settle down, one of the most beta male traits possible. And to settle is the cancer of the soul. You must have an attitude of abundance to be the man you want to be, and have the most fulfilling relationships. If you think you're settled or, she's as good as I can, this pattern will slowly begin to permeate other parts of your life. You must learn how to master the art of attraction and build trust in your ability to meet and date high-quality women with whom you share a relationship. Without this, your whole life will be plagued by the question, what if? If you're not in a committed relationship right now, commit yourself to mastering this area of your life. Spend the next 6 months, all the time on your dating life. Don't forget to wear appropriate clothes. It's simply to say that your clothing should, when called for, reflect the occasion. Don't wear flip-flops to a wedding. Don't wear jeans to a black tie event. Number 7. Please take a stand. Okay, so while it's all too easy to dismiss the alpha as a caveman, a more brutal call to the warrior code, to use fists rather than finesse, all that painfully macho stuff, sometimes it's important. Fighting isn't smart. But there are times when you have to take a stand against bullies, dictators, unthinking politics, or whatever it is that you know wrong. Don't be an audience. At some point in his life, every man should learn how to fight. To be able to defend himself from others in the face of a physical attack. You don't need to be the next Conor McGregor or Floyd Mayweather, but you should know how to hold your own in a physical altercation. Not for self-defense, though it might come in handy someday, but for trust and a sense of accomplishment you derive from experience. It's not a matter of seeking out fights to one-up other men, but of walking this world, knowing that without a shadow of a doubt, if the moment ever comes, you can stand your ground. This changes the way you walk, talk, and show yourself to others. Men may sometimes have a deep-rooted fear that they may not be able to do so, in the event of a physical confrontation. By training in mixed martial arts, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, or boxing, you will develop discipline, self-confidence, and a strong understanding of the mastery process. That feeling you get when you tap on a guy who's bigger and stronger than you are, will carry you over to other areas of life and positively impact everything for the better. Finally, stand tall and speak softly. Stand tall, shoulders back, chest out, literally. Speak your mind and be heard, when the moment arises. grow, don't wilt. Hope you enjoy the video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.